gadget. They don't have the right terms, and when I'm trying to help them, I don't have a clue what they're talking about. So let's learn about these terms. As an example, on this machine, this is the balance wheel or the flywheel. This is called the balance wheel screw or the bobbin winding clutch. Now on this machine over here, this is the balance wheel, and the balance wheel screw is inside here. On this machine, this is the balance wheel, and the balance wheel clutch or screw is here. And so on this machine, this is the balance wheel. Up here is the spool pin. This is a horizontal spool pin with a thread cap. You'll learn more about this system later. On this next machine, this is a pop-up spool pin. This is where you put your thread. On this next machine, you actually have two spool pins. We'll talk more about that later. And on the one over here, the same thing. We have two spool pins. Just to the left of the spool pins is the bobbin winder. There's a bobbin winding spindle, and then on the next machine, there's the bobbin winding spindle. On the next machine, there's the bobbin winding spindle. And on this machine, there is no bobbin winding spindle because on this product, the bobbin winds inside the machine. As we come around here, this gadget that goes up and down, I'm going to try and move this for you, that's called the take-up lever, and it's very, very important. On the machine over here, this is the take-up lever. You can barely see it in here. I don't know if you can see that, but that is very, very important. We're going to talk about that little guy. On this next newer machine, the take-up lever is just barely visible also. Very, very important. And on the last machine, this is how they used to make them. The take-up lever was very, very visible. This is a very, very important part of your sewing machine. We'll talk about this later. Also on the top of your machine is the bobbin winding tension spring. We're going to talk about this later. On this machine, this is the bobbin winder tension spring. On this machine, it's here. And on this last machine, it doesn't exist because, again, the bobbin winds in a different location. Looking at the front of the machine, these dials and levers control the width and the length of your stitch. This is how you get your different looks. On this machine, these levers and dials control your width and your length. On this machine, you have two dials that control your stitch width and length. And on this really old machine, you have a series, again, of levers and dials that control the length of stitch. Looking down at the base of the machine, this is a dial that controls your feed dogs, whether they're in the up position or in the lowered position. Usually the letters will be U for up and D for down, but you'll also find some other terms. Sometimes they call it a silk adjustment and a regular adjustment. On the machine next to this, the feed dog drop is located in the machine in this area here. And basically, there are two adjustments, either up or down. This machine doesn't even have a drop feed mechanism. So if we wanted our feed teeth not to move the fabric forward, we have to actually put a plate over the feed dogs to keep that from happening. Feed dogs are the little guys that make your fabric move when you're sewing. If they're down, they don't move. On this next machine, this is one of the machines that talks about the regular position, the fine position, or the darning position. Basically, it's feed dogs all the way up, halfway up, or all the way down. This section is your presser foot area. There is a presser foot screw. The screw holds the presser foot onto an ankle, and there is your presser foot. In the back of the machine is a presser foot bar. It's a lifting device that raises and lowers the presser foot. As we go to the next machine, again, we'll identify the presser foot. Now, the presser foot lever is over here, and this is the lever that raises or lowers the presser foot. As we go to the next machine, locate the screw, the ankle, the presser foot itself, and the lever that raises and lowers the presser foot. And in this instance, this machine has an upper